afraid to die anymore. I've done it already.
Well, I think we kind of all knew what we were signing up for from the onset, but the weather conditions were the real struggle for all of us. Logistically, we had to go off to far-off, untouched locations in the middle of the wilderness and do very intricate shots and stunts and sequences that involved lots of rehearsal, but it was the changing climate that always was a struggle for us. One day we'd come in and, you know, an entire sequence that we thought was going to be in snow. There'd be no snow for weeks, or the opposite would happen.
Or it was underwater.
It was underwater.
Completely washed down.
Yeah,
you did. You did on land and water. There's a lot of different elements you had to deal with on the shoot. But because it took place in the time period that it took place in, what did you do to get the mindset of how someone would actually live through that sort of situation back then? It's a little different if you get lost in the woods today as opposed to going through that scenario then.
Yeah, very much so. I mean, everything was, I mean, catered to deal with that period in time. So when we arrived, all the elements from design, props, costume, it was focused exclusively on this particular project. So once you got immersed in that world, it was then a question of just picking up as many small pieces as possible to fill out your sight picture on character. So the mindset happened, I think, was started to develop as soon as we arrived on the ground, because it was, you know, corralled to create that.
Right. And we had a lot of people on set that were advisors for us that were very nostalgic about this time period and almost looked at like the mountain man as a spiritual philosophy almost, their integration with nature. But I say it's like, it was kind of like doing a science fiction movie because there's so little written about this time period in America. It's kind of like the Amazon. It was a lawless, untouched landscape. And so We really relied on fur trappers' journals, Native American stories. There were no historians back then, so we had to sort of create this from etchings, you know, so to speak. But it was really the advisors that helped us a lot to understand how they would survive under these harsh conditions and what their mentality was like.
Now, where did
What an incredible honor. Wow, that meant a lot. Thank you so much. Thank you to the HFPA and to the other fantastic performances in this category. You guys were unbelievable. What a terrific year in film. 2 years ago, we found ourselves submerged deep in nature with all of its complications and all the beauty that it gave us cinematically. This film was about survival. It was about adaptation. It was about the triumph of the human spirit, but more than anything, it was about trust. And there's no one more deserving of that trust than our director, Alejandro Iñárritu. Thank you for allowing me to be a part of this journey with you. Your leadership, your vision, your acute attention to making every day so visceral and real for us. I've never had an experience like this in my entire life. The depths to which he and Chivo and the entire crew went through was unfathomable, and I really want to thank the actors that I got to stand shoulder to shoulder with in this film, in particular my good friend Tom Hardy, who is a beast, an unbelievable talent, who was there every single day.
The makeup in this movie is the most incredible makeup I've seen probably in my life. The naturalism of her work is spectacular.
I turn around and get mauled in one of the most incredible cinematic experiences I think audiences will ever have. by a full-grown grizzly bear mother.
Bear attack was particularly challenging.
Bear attacks his arm, so he had an appliance for his arm and also his hand, and his leg gets dislocated.
The whole of Leo's body was covered with prosthetics. It took us 4.5 hours to apply. There were 4 of us working on him almost continuously for that time.
Where hair and makeup has been done, all of that has been around the reality just pouring off the screen, because all that matters is what they get on camera.
The makeup is so important because you have to show all the stages of recovery. You could see the journey in his face.
It's pretty expected.
But the whole movie, it's, and Alejandro, who directed Birdman, I mean, you saw that scene just now where, I mean, how that was even shot. I don't know how he shot that sequence where you're in these rapids.
I don't know how he did a lot of the stuff in this movie. It's one of the most interesting films I've ever been a part of, because we really submerged ourselves in nature, in the natural world, in the elements, and we spent 9 months there, and every day was very unique because we rehearsed all day long, and then we had this hour and a half where we had to capture everything in natural light. But it was quite possibly the most, you know, difficult professional undertaking that I've ever had, and I think I can say the same for everyone that was involved in the movie. It was just a very rough shoot, but the end result is something that is very captivating. You really feel like you're immersed in this world. There's very little CGI. Everything that you see in the movie is
The bear, I mean, I'm assuming that's CGI, but it does not look like it. It's so real. But when you say natural light, that's another thing I don't think people understand. I mean, movies, you're sitting around waiting in a trailer for them to change angles, and everyone's lit. And the director only wanted to shoot natural light, so you only had that 1 hour a day to shoot.
It was like a Saturday Night Live episode every single day, but nothing was funny. It was like live theater. We'd prepare, and it was this constant tension to pull off what we had to pull off in this hour.
My son.
The proper thing to do would be to finish him off quick.
He's to be cared for as long as necessary.
I understand.
Get away! Help!
What happened?
We did what we had to do. He was buried right.
All I had was our boy.